Hey guys, I'm Ben from Authentech, and today I'll be showing you how to turn your phone into an FPV monitor. This brings some sweet features and benefits like saving money, portability, and easy video capture, and more. So let's dive right in. Now, first up, FPV, first person view, is basically a video camera mounted to your drone or RC plane, car, maybe even a boat, stay tuned, wherever. And this broadcasts a live video feed to the pilot. I made a great video in the past, how to FPV anything. Check it out after this one. Now, normally FPV is viewed on a pair of goggles or maybe a monitor. There's great benefits to using these, like the goggles, they're perfect for drone racing, split second reactions, and it feels like you're flying in the cockpit. As a few downsides though, they can often be more expensive, like $100 to $500. Also, you lose line of sight visibility, so you need a spotter. Today we're checking out these sweet little gadgets. They receive that FPV signal, then turn your phone or tablet or even a laptop into your FPV monitor. Now, I've been testing and playing with all four of these different OTG units. Each one is priced slightly different, ranging from $38 at the top all the way down to just 18 bucks. They're all from Banggood. Huge thanks to those guys for sending them. Now, I want to test and see if there is a big difference between each unit, and end of the day, which one is the most bang for your buck. My personal favorite so far is the Schmanke ROTG-02. It seems to be the best balance between price and features. They all come in this convenient little carrying tin, kind of like those old Zippo lighters. Price on this one is currently only $24. I'll give you all the links down below. It's a diversity receiver with two antennas, which can help improve quality and reliability of the signal. It can also support audio playback. I like that it includes two cables, one for older micro USB phones and one USB Type-C for newer devices. It has scan up and down buttons or hold to auto scan all channels and frequencies. It'll show you the strength of the signal and then auto switch you to the strongest frequency. It's very easy and convenient, and I like that visual graph it produces. Latency actually isn't as bad as I thought it might be. Of course, it's not for pro FPV racers. However, you could definitely fly or drive off of it, or even better, use it as a secondary monitor for friends and family to watch, or use it as a very easy way to record that video feed. Many cheaper goggles and monitors out there don't have that micro SD card DVR feature, so this is a nice workaround. Another fun use, use an app that can split the screen into two, then slide your phone into ordinary VR goggles, and now you have that flying in VR effect for super cheap. I saw some comparisons online of the original 01 model versus this updated 02, and honestly, it doesn't seem to make a major difference. So if you want to save about $6, the 01 is currently down to $18, though it's not diversity, but some people say it works just as good as the 02 model. Either way, I don't think you can go wrong with either. The 01 still has the 150 channel auto search function. It works great. Image quality and latency looked good. And for only $18, this one's kind of a steal. Now onto my next favorite is the G model. It's the most expensive one, coming in at $38, but still not that rich and has some cool unique features. It's a diversity receiver as well. It has a built-in rechargeable battery and it has Wi-Fi. So that G model creates its own Wi-Fi hotspot. You download a semi-questionable app to your phone and now you can wirelessly connect to that receiver for that FPV signal. You can start, stop recording, search signal strengths, all wirelessly via Wi-Fi. The latency is gonna be a bit higher on this one, obviously, but it's still a nice picture, and honestly, that wireless connectivity is kinda slick. And last up is that R051. It wouldn't work well for me. I tried a variety of cables and efforts. Finally, I succumbed to downloading their suggested semi-fishy Schmanke app to my Android, which I don't like as much as my FP viewer found in the Play Store. Anyway, swapping out a few more cables and I finally got that feed to patch through. Maybe this one is better for iOS users. I mean, it has a dedicated iOS switch on the unit. Anyway, this one is $29. The micro racing drones that I was using are the DYS Elf. I made a full video on these little quads and they still are some of my all-time favorites. Make sure you check it out after this one. Now, all links to products and videos will be down below. Thank you guys so much for watching and stick around for more tech videos like this one posted every week. Until next time, let's live Authentech.